Hey guys, this is Black Hawk Gaming and we're back with another video. And this is my new series called Zero to Hero. I'm sorry I have not been uploading for quite a while now, but I was busy with other stuff. Anyways, what I'm gonna do in this series is I've started a new game, as you can see. And the reason it's called Zero to Hero is because I start off with zero trophies. And in this new account, I'm gonna try to climb as high as possible on the ladder and, maintain a normal game. As you can see, I've completed all the training arenas and I've got Prince as my epic. And well, let's just, without any further ado, let's just get into it and play our first ever multiplayer battle. So we are level 1 facing another level 1. Drop a good luck. And he's dropped a mini P.E.K.K.A. right off the bag. And let's just see what we can do here. Drop the knight. So just in case the P.E.K.K.A. doesn't move towards the tower. And there's the prince. So, oh my god, what? This guy actually fireballed my king tower. Like, that's the most noobiest thing someone could ever do. And now my prince is charging and I've actually managed to get a split push onto him. So, I feel like I've got the other tower as well. Maybe not. Yeah, no. This is gonna be three crown, guys. I feel like it's gonna be a three crown. It's definitely gonna be a three crown because this guy is just so newbie. I mean, who fireballs the king tower? That's the last thing you want to do. That is another building targeting your troops. So we've got some giant, we have got a giant and some archers targeting the tower, and that's enough for the three crown. First game, three crown victory, 30 trophies plus. Well, my internet has slowed down from the morning. But I don't think that should be a problem. Let's jump into the second battle. Okay, another level one yet again. Mini Rafa. I hope I'm pronouncing the name right. Okay, this guy is not messing around. He probably knows what he's doing. Or maybe it's just too soon to say. Okay. I think I should have lured him in a little more. Oh my god. Oh god. Second noob I've faced in my second game. You should never fireball a giant. Instead, use that 4 elixir to defend the giant or probably build up another good defense which can counter as well. Guys, it's a game of patience. If you have a giant coming towards you, please do not throw a fireball or an arrow at it. I mean, it doesn't work. What would you possibly achieve by doing that? And I've just thrown a prince to counter the giant. And as you can see, what I've tried to do here, I have put a prince which is an attacking troop in defensive mode so that he can even run forward to attack. And now this genius has just used his arrows. To be honest, at this point in the game, prince is just an OP troop. And there's not much we can do to stop him because we don't have many cheap troops like the goblins or stuff. Goblins are a perfect shutdown, skeletons are a perfect shutdown, but you should know how and when to pull the prince over. And there's another 3 crown, 30 plus trophies, and another silver chest. Okay, so as I was saying, you should try to drag him around the arena so that your tower gets more time to hit him and take him out. And I've only got the goblins, as you can see, it's level 1, so I'm not using it. So in case I face the prince, I would have to use my archers as a distraction. Okay, we're facing a level 2, Moin 2. It's probably second account because, I mean, it says 2 right there, so it's probably second account, I'm guessing. Let's just see, I'll start off a giant at the back. Okay, which? Probably not. Who would do that? A lone witch is the most stupidest push you could ever do. I mean, at higher levels, it's like naked hog rider, which will get easily countered. And I've built up a strong counter. He has a musketeer who's defending, and the bomber just got wiped out before he could get a shot off. Goblins, right? I think we have this tower, guys. Yes, we do. I just like the archers, to get some shots off. Okay. Not the best of, play from me. I shouldn't have done that. Oh, no. He could have used his cheap goblins. Why would he do that? Maybe he didn't have them in cycle. Okay, this is gonna do massive damage to his tower. There's nothing he can do probably to defend it. He can probably take out the archers and the musketeer now, but I hardly see what he can do right now. And that's another 3 turn for us, guys. We're technically at equal trophies, so now I get 30 plus 90 trophies. So I need one more crown and I'll wrap up this episode because there wouldn't be left, I mean there wouldn't be much left to do. So anyways, let's just jump into the last battle. Okay, level 2. Name is written in Chinese, so I can't read it. For obvious reasons, I don't know Chinese. Let's put a musketeer down. Musketeer was I'm gonna arrow that and I hope it take okay. It's not high enough to take out the archers. Oh my god, the musketeer can't. If I'm not wrong, the musketeer can't lock on from that room. Oh, bad play, bad play. This is a complete shutdown. I should have waited. Anyways, he has dropped a bomber and he has put. Wait, how did he cycle back so quick? Spear goblin. Okay, this guy is actually putting me under a lot of pressure right now, but since he dropped a skeleton army, then he has nothing to defend the prince except for these cheap goblins, which will get taken out. I'm gonna drop a giant just so that. Okay, it was of no use. I couldn't save the archers anyway. Okay, oh my god, this is gonna be great value, guys. This is gonna be great value. So as you could see, this was a very positive elixir trade as I took out, let's get counting, 6, 7, 9. I took out 10 elixir with only 3 elixir. That was like the sickest elixir trade anyone could ever have. I'm gonna fireball that. Oh, I missed the musketeer. What a noob. I mean, playing so horribly at this level is completely inexcusable because how could I miss the musketeer? Fireball is my first team regular. I keep using a lot of fireball, so I'm just gonna let him take that tower because I want the second tower for some reason. I just feel like I need the second tower. So yeah, you can go take that tower, okay? So he's probably done at this point because there's nothing much he can do. He has used up all his elixir on my left lane. And as you can see, I'm gonna drop the bomb. Okay, I didn't get the chance to drop the bomber, but GG, I dropped the good luck. So that's it from me for this episode, guys. Stay tuned for more Clash Royale action, and I'll be back with another 0-to-Hero episode. Please like, comment, and subscribe, and share the video with your friends. Stay tuned for more. Thank you for watching. Hey guys, this is Black Hawk Gaming, and we're back with another video. And this is my new series called 0-to-Hero. I'm sorry I have not been uploading for quite a while now, but I was busy with other stuff. Anyways, what I'm gonna do in this series is I've started a new game, as you can see. And the reason it's called 0-to-Hero is because I start off with 0 trophies. And in this new account, I'm gonna try to climb as high as possible on the ladder and maintain a normal game. As you can see, I've completed all the training arenas and I've got Prince as my epic. And well, without any further ado, let's just get into it and play our first ever multiplayer battle. So we are level 1 facing another level 1. Drop a good luck. And he's dropped a mini P.E.K.K.A. right off the bag. And let's just see what we can do here. Drop the knight. So just in case the P.E.K.K.A. doesn't move towards the tower and